happened in the Gaza Strip recently. America protects Israel against all those votes in the United Nations, and there are usually no consequences whatsoever. We continue to give them billions of dollars of American taxpayer money, no matter what they do in those situations. No, Netanyahu's government is a little bit in trouble because of corruption. Wow, a right-winger in any country that actually wants to enrich himself and be part of the elites and does corruption to do so. I would have never seen that coming. Well, in this case, it also involves his wife, so we're going to go to the Associated Press here. They report that Israeli prosecutors on Thursday charged the wife of Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu with misusing over $100,000 in public funds to order lavish meals from some of the country's most famous chefs. Let them eat bread. She's already got her own chef, but she's, no, not enough. I got to misuse government funds to get more lavish food from different chefs. Well, I do declare. Now, this is, by the way, the good part of Israel's democracy. It's sometimes unfair to call it a democracy because the Palestinians in the Gaza Strip and West Bank don't have a democracy, and Israel rules over them. So it's not really a democracy. But there are good parts of Israel's democratic movements, and at least the ones that it applies to, including Israeli citizens. And they actually do a very good job of fighting against corruption, and they brought up a lot of corruption charges. I think they do a way better job than America does. So let me give you more details about this. They explain that Sara Netanyahu has long faced allegations of abusive behavior and living extravagantly. In 2016, a court ruled she abused an employee and awarded the man $42,000 in damages. That's what the court did. They awarded him that amount of money. Other former employees have accused her of mistreatment, charges that the Netanyahus have vehemently denied. Someone married to Benjamin Netanyahu abusing people underneath her. No! Netanyahu would never abuse anyone. And for someone that he lives with to do that, the charges, well, I do declare, I'm quite shocked by this. Her husband abuses people for a living, basically. I mean, are you ever going to let the people go in the Gaza Strip or the West Bank? Are you ever going to stop occupying them? This is the least surprising news I have ever seen. So once you become callous to the fate of other human beings and their identity, their feelings, their humanity, is it surprising to somebody who works for you, you would also abuse? And by the way, these are not my allegations. I'm just reporting what happened in Israel. The courts in Israel already awarded these damages. So it happened. Now, back to today. In Thursday's indictment, the Justice Ministry says Sara Netanyahu was charged with graft, fraud, and breach of trust for allegedly overspending more than $100,000 on private meals at the Prime Minister's official residence, even when there was a full-time chef on staff. There is no end to the avarice and the greed of those in charge. So whether it's the elites here in America or really anywhere across the world or, in this case, Israel, no. Please, my private chef will not suffice. Okay, why don't you pay out of your own pocket? You're incredibly wealthy and, you know, the Netanyahus have been in power for a long time. Why are you charging the Israeli taxpayers? Nah, I just want extra chefs, and I want you to pay for it. Lock her up. These are crimes against the Israeli people, and they should be taken very seriously, and I'm glad to see that they are. If convicted, she could face a maximum sentence of 5 years behind bars, though that seems unlikely, according to the Associated Press. Yes, we all know that there is unequal justice across the world. The rich and powerful get different rules. The rest of us get incredibly harsh sentences. Now, again, all the credit in the world to the Israeli justice system here as they are pursuing these corruption charges vigorously. We'll see if she actually serves any prison time. That would be amazing. Because we're so used to the powerful getting away with everything. But let's see. These are very serious charges. The indictment threatens to reinforce the unflattering reputation the Netanyahus have gained for enjoying an expensive lifestyle out of touch with most Israelis. Netanyahu also faces several police investigations into his alleged corruption. Now, that's on a much bigger scale. I'm going to tell you about that in 1 second. But how did Benjamin Netanyahu respond to this? He called it a, quote, witch hunt. Where have I seen that before? Okay, yes, birds of a feather flock together. So Trump and Netanyahu, with their endless corruption, keep telling us, no, 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 it's not me, it's not my family. It's all these people who are aligned against me. They're doing a witch hunt. They made your wife get all those food from the chefs, the fancy chefs. I don't even know what to call them. I mean, God, look at how out of touch they are, man. That they can't just eat normal food. They can't just eat expensive food. They can't even just have their own private chef prepare them food. No, I've got to get it from all of the best chefs. And I've got to make you pay for it. Okay? So that's very typical. Now, that's $100,000. But now that's a lot. If you're an Israeli taxpayer, you should be livid about that. But get a load of how much bigger the issue is for Benjamin Netanyahu, the prime minister. Israeli police questioned Netanyahu, his wife, and son last week in a connection to a corruption case involving the country's telecom giant, Bezeq. Netanyahu is suspected of promoting regulations worth hundreds of millions of dollars for the company in return for more favorable coverage of the Netanyahu family on the telecom company's influential news site. Now, that's some significant corruption. Israeli prosecutors have at it, Hoss. So their job is to protect the Israeli people.